God, more text. This is what I get for turning on tips. If you must responding. God, this music is so loud. It's 1 sec. All right, that helps a bit for me. Responding to calls is the bread and butter of police work. You'll need to send your officers to the crime scene before the timer expires. A mark on the map shows where the call came from. The farther away the destination is from the police station, the longer it will take your officers to travel back and forth. So the longer your people will be tied up and unavailable for upcoming work. Okay. The easiest way to determine a difficult task might be is to check how many units you are allowed to send on the call. The more units you can send, the more serious the alleged threat. Particularly risky missions give you the option of sending squads, but they must be accompanied by at least one officer. Okay. Oh, God, so much. Okay. The number of slots is not the only thing to consider. Any available information from the location of the crime scene to the presence of weapons and so on. All of this can tell you how serious each case should be taken. The mission might look simple at first glance until it turns into a brutal meat grinder. Or a serious call can come in which turns out to be a false alarm. A married couple exited a convenience store and saw a van. Is the timer still going? I don't think so. A van in the parking lot, back over a homeless man who'd been digging through a trash can. The driver jumped out to help, but once he saw that he hit a bum, he got back in the van and quickly drove away. Okay, so this sounds like a pretty just simple statement gathering, so we're going to just put our very reliable officer on the case. Last picture shows theater. A theater manager reports that during the show of Citizen Kane, a drunk man attempted to force his way. God damn, this music is loud. I turn this way down. There, now maybe I won't have to talk so loud because it's hurting my throat. Citizen Kane, a drunk man, attempted to force his way into the theater carrying a snowboard decorated with the word Rosebud. When he was denied entry, he violently attacked the cashier and is currently fighting with the theater security guard. Okay, we're gonna send two people. These are some, like, interesting calls. I hope we get calls from a library because I work at a library and goddamn. Okay, so this is the report. When everything goes well, the police capture the criminals and nobody dies. But the truth is, sometimes the criminals manage to escape. Just try to avoid any dead cops or civilians. Dead cops will hurt your roster, and dead civilians bother the mayor even more than living ones. Offender caught, officer unharmed. Okay, good. So now one of our best cops will be coming back. Yay! So we're doing pretty good so far. I wonder how often calls will come in. Is this going to... I mean, I don't really remember. Okay, so three teenagers armed with a shotgun robbed a videotape store. When does this take place? And made off with their whole collection of adult movies. The criminals fled in a car, but the store manager wrote down the car's license plate. The owner is one Janet Brown who lives in the suburbs. So this is pretty cut and dry. But since there is a shotgun involved, we're gonna send two officers. Fight. A brother and sister clashed with each other over their deceased father's will. According to one of their lawyers, we don't dare separate them, and our security guard is off duty tonight. Oh, well, that sucks for you, buddy. All right, let's send two people. Anytime family is involved, you don't want just one person dealing with that. You need to separate the two, have two separate people talking to them at the same time. It's kind of like kids when you, when they're opening gifts on Christmas. You don't want one to have a chance to talk before, or to open them before the other, because the other one's going to get jealous, and you get it. Alright, a passerby saw some teenagers attack an elderly musician, then run away with his guitar and his money. Alright, so violence against the elderly, we're going to... Do we get put all three? I think two will probably be enough. Uh-oh. When your cops aren't sure how to proceed, they might contact you and ask you how to handle the situation. Try to deal with whatever comes up, but don't waste all your time on this stuff. You have plenty of other problems on your plate. So the vehicle in question is parked right outside the Brown residence. The sounds of moaning and loud laughter can be heard through the living room window. So they're watching the tapes. Turn on the siren and loudspeaker and shout that the house is surrounded. Let's scare the shit out of these kids. There we go. And this is the full version. Yay! So this is kind of like a nice, relaxing game. I actually don't really remember this hardly at all. It's a nice, relaxing, this kind of lull in between. I can see how some people may not have liked it on Steam. And yay! So far, I think that's all of our... Everyone that was currently out. Everyone came back, we're good! And it's the end of the day! We're just gonna wait for these two, last two to come. And we're good. If you think you'll need a couple of extra hands tomorrow, you can order any cop to come in and work overtime. But if they're working flat out, they'll be much more exhausted. Somebody's bound to make a mistake. Okay. So we're just gonna end the shift.
Used to be when I asked Kendrick to stay late at the office, he liked to grumble and crack wise. Nowadays, he doesn't have the strength for it. Slumped shoulders, blank stare, wrinkled skin. The past few weeks, I don't hardly recognize my old friend. In his younger years, he reminded me of a gallant royal officer in an old Kipling story. Kendrick isn't just crumbling under the weight of the public pressure, but from the shame of it all. Internal Affairs raided the library he inherited from his grandfather, hoping they'd find buckets of cash stashed in the pages. Heard about the look on his face, the fearless policeman standing helpless in horror. I've known Francis for 30 years. The past 20 years he's played loose with the law. And I know that at a certain point every stolen dollar brings more misery than anything else. Probably sounds crazy, but I sympathize with the guy. What can I do? Your friends are your friends, and these are the waters we swim in.
Called all of the people on that list today. Now they know you're in business, so you could get a call from any of them. You don't need to worry about any of them. I've cleared them all.
And what kind of business are we talking here?
It's nothing too serious, just like you asked. Should be just a few small favors. Payments will vary depending on the situation and who you're dealing with. How much are you looking to earn?
$500,000.
$500,000? Why not a whole million?
Because everybody wants to take a million. Figured I'd try something different.
Half a million in 180 days? Well, you could earn it all above board if you netted all the big fish and hit all your bonuses.
Never knew you for a fisherman.
Well, you never got into my business, and I'm not trying to get into yours. But be careful about bringing in any other cops. Sooner or later, they'll put the finger on you. And one more thing, Jack. I remember what you said, but I should probably add one more name to that list. Christopher Sand.
Sand. Christopher G. Sand. Everyone knows the name, but few could tell you who he is. The old man stays away from the spotlight. Always wears old-fashioned jeans and knitted sweaters. Gives to charity. Rarely attends social events. An avid hunter, I hear. Even dabbles in poetry. You'd never guess he's the head of the oldest and most powerful gang in the city. Goes back as far as his great-grandfather. And Sand is strict about following the old rules. He rarely involves himself in commonplace murders and robberies. Hardly needs to intimidate anyone to get his point across. The people who work for him each have their sphere. They provide protection where needed, even work with the authorities when they want to make a deal. Meanwhile, Sand pulls the strings without getting his hands dirty. People sometimes mistake his quiet approach. A couple years ago, an arms dealer decided to expand its business without asking permission, and his whole family paid the price. In 4 weeks, Sand killed 31 people. Old men, women, even a few teenagers. And Sand's people made sure every paper reported it. Frank, I don't want to hear you say that name again.
Jack, please, listen to me. I'm in with these guys.
We agreed, Frank. That's not the kind of business I'm into. I don't go there. Never have, never will.
All right. Francis Kendrick announces retirement date, construction of cinema museum postponed again, and legendary singer Gennaro Crespo comes to Freeburg. Alright, when a police officer is too tired to be effective, he will ask for a day off. Sometimes officers will request days off even when they are at full strength. Some of the reasons you'll hear are far-fetched, while some are very serious. Don't overindulge your subordinates, but don't antagonize them either. Remember that everybody's got secrets and you've got to make sure these guys have your back. Okay. In addition to their performance ratings, In addition to performance ratings, police officers also possess rank. Officers begin at the lowest rank and can be elevated in rank with 1, 2, or 3 stripes. Once a week, you can pass out stripes and improve the ranking of any employee. If you think that no one is worthy of the honor some week, you can postpone the ceremony until later. Insignias won't go out until your people are ready. Okay. Okay, so let's go ahead and give one to, can I not, it says I still have 2 stripes to give out. There we go. And let's go ahead and give him another one. There we go. He has 500, like, he clearly has done more than anyone else. So he gets all 3 stripes, he's ready to go. Fredericksburg isn't one of those cities where you listen to what they say or not. Wait. Fredericksburg isn't one of those cities where you listen to what they say or nothing at all. You can always select any song from your collection and play it anytime. Just like in real life. Well, the life of your grandfather. Okay. Well, we might as well listen to each record. Let's learn how to hire and fire cops. You have a certain number of paid job openings for which you can hire any available applicant. Job slots are separated between officers and detectives. Okay. So, let's hire for shift A. Is that it? I think the game froze. Oh, no, it didn't. Okay. Want to free up a slot? Time to fire somebody. No, I'm not firing him! I am not firing him! No! I just gave him the stripes! I'm not... I don't like him! Ha! Well, now I think I might have really broken the game. Oops. What did I do? I'll fire the one that has, like, the 5 on reputation, but not this guy. Shit, I think I fucked up. I can't even select him again. Alright, I will be right back. I'm gonna shut this down and load it back up and try again.